Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Good morning, Grace. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah. How many of you are excited about Jesus raising from the dead for us? Huh? Come on and give him a praise. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. You deserve our praise. Hallelujah, God. We thank you, God, for everybody that is here, Jesus. God, everybody that's on their way, bless them right now in the name of Jesus. We expect to have an encounter with you today, oh God. Hallelujah. We are going to bless the name of the Lord. Yeah. Hallelujah, Jesus. My God, my God. When I think about what he's done for me, when I think about how he set me free, I get excited. Yay. Yay, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. God, we thank you, Lord, for all that you have done, Jesus. Yes, God, bless your holy name. Have your way, Jesus. Do what only you can do. Hallelujah. Let's just bless his name one more time right there. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Well, listen, I'm a little bit excited because I'm just, when I think about what God has done for me, man. Yeah. Ooh. So the thing about it is when Jesus is in the room, there's freedom. And I'm not sure what you came in here with today, but I want to remind you that you're free. Whom the Son sets free is truly free indeed. Hallelujah. And so the song we're going to sing says, let freedom fill the room. Hey. Let's go. From heaven that changes everything. I am free, no fear is holding me. Nothing can stop my praise. Oh, we were made for freedom. Jesus has redeemed us, my friend. Yeah, yeah. Oh, sing it out together. Jesus reigns forever and ever. Let freedom fill the room. Hey. Oh. Let freedom fill the room. Oh. Oh. Hey. Come on. Hear the sound. A sound from heaven that changes everything. Oh, let praise the Lord right now in the name of Jesus. If he's done anything for you, God, you're deserving of our praise, oh God. Yes, God. Jesus, oh God, how he rose from the dead. Oh, I get excited, I get excited. We're free, we're free, we're free. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. He is risen, he is risen. He is alive, he is alive, he is alive. Therefore, we have hope. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus, we bless you. We bless you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Our God is risen. He is alive. He won the victory. He reigns on high. Our God is risen, he is alive. He won the victory, he reigns on high. Come on, let's sing it, Grace. Hallelujah. Yeah. You have won the victory. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have won it all for me. Come on, say, death could not hold you down.
Oh, God. Yes.
You are the risen King. Seated in majesty. You are.
Yeah. King of kings and the Lord of lords. We worship
worship you, Almighty God, because of you, we are victorious, mighty God. Thank you for healing our hearts. Thank you for making us the way you want us to be, mighty God. Not by power, not by might, but by spirit, says the Lord, of God Almighty. Worthy, 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 worthy is the Lord, of God Almighty. We worship you, Almighty God. Thank you for dying for us. Thank you for taking our pain from us. Thank you for giving us a healing, Almighty God. Healer is a healer, Almighty God. Touch and see that the Lord is good. In the name of Jesus, we praise you, Almighty God. Amen, 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 amen.
Happy Resurrection Sunday. You are looking good this Sunday morning. Y'all seem excited to be in the house of the Lord. It's like y'all know y'all could have been in other places. But His wisdom and mercy has brought you here today. Well, you can be seated. And we have three annual special offerings each year. And this Sunday, we're going to celebrate resurrection, the resurrection of Jesus. And we're dedicating this resurrection offering to the hurting in our communities. So 50% of what comes in today will go towards Grace Cares, where we are serving organizations throughout the D.C. area, helping dozens of local charities feed the hungry, clothe those in need, and assist the abused. So thank you for what you do. And all we ever ask you to do for these special offerings, just pray about it. The other half is going to be used for our children. Our young people are growing. And we're going to install an interactive, immersive screen into the youth area. And by the way, they are developing their own worship team. They have their own ushers, their own greeters. Yeah. Soon they'll have their own band, so we want to make it happen for them, and we want them to be able to receive digital instruction and all that. So as we sow into God's work today, let's believe this. Let's believe that what we help make happen for others, God will help make happen for us and for those we love, all right? So Pastor, would you read the scripture for us today?
Yes. We are standing on Proverbs 11:25 today. The generous soul will be made rich, and he who waters will also be watered himself. As we bless others, we have the confidence that God would also take care of us. Amen. And if you have your envelopes,
you need an envelope. Yeah, just lift your hand up,
yeah,
and we'll get it to you.
Thank you, Dada. Yes, and you are in the hand of the ushers. God bless.
Also, there are 8 ways to give. They're showing on the screen, or 6 or something. So however you want to participate, just do it. All right. We're good. We'll be back up in a second. All right.
Come on, are there any thankful people in the room this morning? Come on, stand up to your feet.
I was wandering into the night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul, this bag of bones.
Come on, is this your testimony?
And I tried with all my might, but I just can't win the fight. I'm slowly drifting, oh, a vagabond. But just when I ran out of road, I met a man I didn't know, and he told me that I was not alone.
Come on, lift it up, Grace, sing it out, say.
He turned me around, he placed my feet, said, I thank the Master. Somebody thank your Savior, because he healed my heart, he changed my Master, said I thank you, Savior.
Come on, shout it out, Grace. Say,
I said, I thank God. Said, I thank God. Come on, one more time. Said, I thank God. Come on, now I need you to sing this part with me if you're free this morning. Shout to the heavens, I am free. Yeah, I am free. Oh, I am free. Sing it out, great. Yeah, that's it. Sing it out. Say, shout to. Come on, if you're free this morning. Purchase your freedom. Hey. Yeah. Said I am free. Oh, I am free. Say shout out to the heaven. Said I am free. I am free. He's freed me. He's saved me. Said I am free. Oh, I am free. Say oh, because he picked me up. He turned me around. He placed my. Master, say I thank the Savior because He healed my heart. He changed my name. I'm forever free. Said I thank the Master. Said I thank the Savior. Said I thank. Said I thank God. Hey, hey. Said I thank God. Come on now, are you ready to speak to some dead things in your life? Come on, let's prophesy. Sing this out, say, get up, get up, get up, hey, get up out of that grave. Sing it out, grave. Yeah. Come on, sing it out. Woo. Sing it out, say. Say, get up, get up, say, get up out of that grave. Say, get up, get up, get up, get up out of that grave. Say, get up, get up, get up, get up out of that grave. Say, get up. Get up out of that grave.
offering. Come on, give what's yours. We bless you, Lord. Seems like it's going to be that type of Sunday. Yeah. Hold on. We got to hold on for a sec. All right. We're going to pray. How many of y'all need some things, God, to turn around? Yeah. He's about to do it. You don't often hear me say this, but I believe there's healing in the room right now. And those of you with needs in your body, just check and see if the pain is still there. And if it's gone, just give us a shout, and we can praise the Lord with you. All right. That's what I expect to see. Father, we thank you for this offering. Fathers, we serve the community and feed those that are hungry, those that need clothing, those that are dealing with abuse. Father, multiply the seed sown back to those who gave so they can have more to give to advance your kingdom. Father, would you just stretch your hands toward these resources? Father, we thank you for the ability to be a blessing to the DMV and places around the globe, and we give you the honor for what you do. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Our videos are coming up.
Good morning, Grace. Good morning. Yes. Look, y'all look great this morning. And you can tell my Lord is in the room, that's for sure. Yes. Yes, he is. Well, as you all know, that this is a very special time here at Grace. This is the time where we mention some very important people, our VIPs. If this is your first time worshiping with us, we want to show you some Grace love. For our on live streaming family, we love you guys. And if you are here or if you're on live stream for the first time, please put in the chat, say your name, tell us where you're from, and we are so excited to bless you. But if you are here in the sanctuary for the first time, we ask that you stand. We're not here to embarrass you. We just want to show you some grace, love, and give you a little gift. Any first timers? Yes, welcome you guys, welcome. Like I said, we are so happy to have you here, and we pray that something that has been said or done impacts your life for the better. And just like that, you went from first-time visitors to what, Grace?
Family.
Yes, family, yes. You guys, today is Resurrection Sunday, Grace. It's Resurrection Sunday, yes. Yes, he has risen, you guys, and let me just say, y'all showed up and showed out for the Lord today, yes, all in the Sunday best, and you guys know I love a good outfit, so thank you so much. Now, Pastor Dexter Nuttall will be speaking at our next RLN session, Friday, April 12th at 11 a.m. RLN provides monthly leadership training sessions and coaching from top leaders, pastors, speakers, and influencers. Our passion is to help leaders unlock their potential, see measurable results, and create a lasting impact in the world. So please register today at rlnleadership.com/RLN, please. So thank you, Grace, so much for participating in the Waffle fundraiser for the gym. Yes. The gym youth had a great time making and selling the waffles, and you guys went above and beyond the expectations. And honestly, guys, this is really important. I remember when I went to Forward when I was younger, even though I'm still young, but when I was younger, and it was an amazing experience. I was blessed to be in that room full of other young people who wanted to praise and uplift the Lord. So thank you guys so much for showing up and doing a fundraising opportunity. Thank you. Yes. And because of your faithfulness and generosity that we're able to send our youth to this life-changing conference, for more details about Forward or to donate, go to gracechurchva.org/forward, okay? Thank you. Now, as we prepare for our next time of worship in the Word, please be considerate and silence all mobile devices. Keep in mind, people are making important decisions that will impact their eternity. If your child becomes fussy, cries, or distracts others during the time of ministry, please take your little one to our family room or the foyer area where they will have freedom to run around. Our friendly ushers, hashtag B team. Our friendly ushers are available to assist you if needed. Also, our amazing Kids Quest and nursery are available. Lastly, please limit walking during the time of the Word and altar call. All consideration makes a difference. Thanks, Grace, and happy Resurrection Sunday.
Amen. Okay, pantsuit. She wearing it, ain't she? Good morning, Grace. Happy Resurrection Sunday. We're going to sing an old song. Bread of Heaven. You are the living word. There we go. The song speaks to who God is, who God was, and who he's going to be. So let's worship our Lord today, okay? Amen.
Bread of Heaven, sent down from glory, many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter, you are the living word, say, sent down from glory, many things.
They
awesome ruler, Gentile Redeemer.
Gentle Redeemer.
It's God with us.
God with us, the living truth. And what a friend we have in you.
You are an awesome ruler.
Awesome ruler.
Gentile Redeemer.
Gentle Redeemer.
It's God with us.
The living truth, and what a friend we have in you.
In you.
You are the living word.
Worship our Father. My saving word.
You are my saving word.
Yes, you are my saving word.
You are my saving word.
Every word belongs to you, oh God.
You are my saving word.
Say you are my saving word.
You are my saving word.
Oh, thank you, Father. Because he lives. I can face tomorrow, because he lives, all fear is gone. because I know. And life is worth the living just because he lives. Ah, God, sorry. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear has got to go. Because I know, he holds your future. And life is worth the living, just Jesus. And life is worth the living, just. And life is the living, just because he lives. Because he
Jesus, come on, just for a second. Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Jesus. Lord teaches us how to pray. Stay standing for a moment. And when Jesus teaches us, he starts and tells us, say, hallowed be thy name. And what he's saying to us is that prayer should begin with worship and praise. We should enter his gates and his courts before we petition and ask. Yes. So right now we're gonna shift up and switch up from hallowed be thy name to thy will be done. Yes. On earth as it is in heaven. Yes. So right now we're gonna turn this place into an altar. Would you touch elbows or hands, whatever you're comfortable with. And I want you to pray for that person on your right. Jesus. Jesus, and on your left, you don't know what they came through to get here today, and you don't know what they're going into. Jesus. Right now, come on, pray. Come on, pray. Come on, he's in the room. He's in the room. He's in the room. He's in the room. Oh, he's in the room. Jesus is in the room. Oh, He's in the room. Jesus is in the room. He's 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 in the room. Whatever you need. He's in the room. 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 Whatever you need, he's in the room. Jesus is in the room. God is in the room. God is in the room. Healing is in the room. Healing's in the room. Redemption. It's in the room. It's in the room. Effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much. Call on him, call on him, call on him, call on him, call. Name above every name that can be named. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, help us, Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus. Get free right now. God's touching you. God's touching you. Get free. Shake it off. Shake it off. Get free. Break those bands. Get free. Freedom. 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 Get free. 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 Freedom. 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 Been loosed, loosed. Be free, be free. Go and put your hand on your head. I'm free, I'm free. I'm free, I'm free. Whom the sun sets free is free indeed. Whom the sun sets free is free indeed. Whom the sun sets free. I'm free, I'm free. We're free, Jesus. Hallelujah. There's healing in this place. I'm going to get into the message in just a moment, but there's healing in this room. Christ is the healer. By his stripes, you've been healed. Right now, touch that place you used to have pain and move that thing you couldn't move. Watch God do what only God can do. He's a healer. Jesus. Before we make that move, just gonna pause in his presence and Jesus, 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 you're a healer. All of you that need healing in your body, would you come up front real quick? Come up front. I know we don't normally do this, but if you need healing in your body, come up front, come up front. He's a healer. He's a healer. Waymaker, Waymaker, miracle worker, miracle worker. Hallelujah. Jesus. Come on, just make your way. Now listen, as folks come, I need the deacons and the altar workers. Listen, Bible says lay hands on the sick and they'll recover. Listen, I can't heal you, I can't fix you, I don't have that type of power. But I do have hands. And my faith is today, and if you're watching by live stream, listen, I don't know, put your hand on something, if it's your phone, you can, whatever you're watching, God wants to touch you. He wants to touch people in this room. And here's the deal. Yeah. I'm going to ask the deacons and the altar workers, and it doesn't matter whose hand it is. It's obedience to Jesus. And Jesus said, if you lay hands on the sick, they'll recover. So, some of y'all are going to get it like that. Others of you is going to take time. Like the man that first saw men like trees, and then he saw everything clearly. And what I'm going to ask now, would you quickly, leaders, just touch everybody on the head. Just touch them. Release your faith. Release your faith. Release your faith. Release your faith. Come on, come on, touch him, touch him, touch him. Not long prayer. We got to get to the word. Just a touch, and then touch the next. Go on, just a touch, touch the next. Touch the next, touch the next. Yeah, just a touch, touch the next. Just a touch. A simple touch. Come on, he's resurrected. We are the body of Jesus. We are his healing arms, his healing hands. Yeah, touch, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Come on, just touch, touch, touch. Yeah, yeah. Come. Yeah. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Complete rest of Jesus. Right there, there it is, right there. In Jesus' name, Jesus, Jesus. Come on, touch him quickly. Come on, leaders, touch him quickly. Touch him quickly. Come on, touch him quickly. After hands have been laid, just go back to your seat. God's doing a work, God's doing a work. Power in the room. Miracles, signs, and wonders. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Come on, touch him quickly, touch him quickly. Touch him quickly. Come. Jesus, Jesus. Complete recovery, complete. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Loose the tongues in Jesus' name. All right, come. Quickly. Come on, altar workers, let's get it done. Just put your hands and there you go. Get it done. And whoever's waiting, come quickly. Yeah. Jesus. Go, just put your hand on them. There you go. The Bible says the prayer offered in faith shall save the sick. Come on, put your hand on it. Come on, put your hand. Yeah, put your hand. Come. Yeah, right there, Carson. There you go. Put your hand. Thank you. Jesus. Complete healing and restoration. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Thank you.
happening, it's happening. Come on, Waymaker, what?
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. That is who you are.
Y'all came to have church today. Overflow. Overflow. Are you with us? Are you with us? Come on, overflow. Yeah. Woo. Y'all gotta give me an extra 10 minutes. Y'all pulling on the healing anointing of Jesus. You know, we have, in our old building, we have five different parking lots. And the reason we built this one is because folks had to get on buses, get off buses to get to the services. It was just a whole thing. So we decided as a church, we'd build a facility with 10 acres of parking. But guess what? Every single spot is full this Resurrection Sunday. And folks are in overflow. And next year we will have a sunrise service to make room for everyone. So those of you that want to, you know, get through this thing around 6:30, I think it will be. We will do it next year. Father, open eyes, illuminate hearts. Father, healing's already happened. And there's no distance in the spirit. Those that have live streaming, if God's touched you, he's touched you. And just accept it and walk in it. Father, we thank you for your word. Meet us in this time of study. And we will give you all the honor and all the glory. And the church says, amen, amen, amen. Today's message is for people who've gone through seasons of doubt. People who have faced moments where the gulf between their current reality and where they expected to be at this point in their life got so wide they started to fall in. And we're going to pick up in John chapter 20, verse 24, because one of Jesus' disciples was right there too. John says, now Thomas, not a lot is known about the apostle, Thomas. Tradition says that he took the gospel to India and then he died a martyr there. The oldest American to ever live, her name was Sarah Noss, at least on record. She died December 30th, 1999, at 119 years of age and 97 days. And I said that to say that all of us in one way or another are doing time. And none of us can be exactly sure when our release date will be. Kobe Bryant got out in 41 years. Luke Perry, 52. Chadwick Boseman, 43. Matthew Perry, 54. Michael Jackson, 50. Hector Camacho, 50. Tupac, only 25. When it's all over, our greatest regrets will not be the cars we didn't drive, the people we didn't meet, the places we didn't go, but the choices we didn't make for the one who lent us our lives in the first place. Now, Thomas called the twin. Some speculate that Thomas was actually Matthew's brother, because they're always listed together in the Bible. Now, we know for a fact that Peter and Andrew were brothers. We know that James and John were brothers. And if it were so that Matthew and Thomas were brothers, it would mean that half of the disciples served God with their families. Now, this would not surprise me, because God does not desire to save any of us in isolation. He reaches you intending you to reach back and grab the others. Now, Thomas called the twin one of the 12. Now, we all know our Bibles well enough to know that when Judas betrayed Jesus with a kiss and the soldiers arrested him, all of the disciples scattered except Judas. But then we find in the Bible that they all came back together to watch the crucifixion from a distance. But only John had the courage to stay at the foot of the cross with Mary. And may we all have the courage of John. They all thought and had been trained, they'd watched his miracles and his life, and they thought that Jesus was the Messiah. But after the crucifixion, they began to think, how could a dead man bring everlasting peace? How could a dead man bring justice to our world? Has anyone ever experienced a disappointment so devastating, so heartbreaking, so faith-shattering, that all you could do after it was over is relate to God from a distance? This was the case of all the disciples. They stood away from the cross and they could just kind of see from far away. And particularly, this is where Thomas was. And it says, one of the 12 was not with them when Jesus came. All of them were in incredible pain. But on the Sunday after resurrection, Thomas was the only one who had not returned to church. He was in so much pain, he began to isolate. And Thomas was the only one out of the remaining 11 that missed Christ's appearing. You see, we don't usually miss church because we live far away from the building, but mostly because something happened that made us far away from God. One of the 12 was not with them when Jesus came. You know, we don't all grieve alike. Some longer, some shorter. Some get angry, some get depressed, some get confused. But Thomas grieved by becoming absent. And this is really one of the worst ways to grieve. It says, the other disciples therefore said to him, now he didn't show for church, but the good thing is he didn't go into complete isolation. Others could still reach him. He still allowed others to speak into his life. You see, we can't isolate ourselves and at the same time get upset because there's no one there to help. It takes two to stay connected. Ecclesiastes 4 and verse 9 says, two are better than one because they have a good reward for their labor. And what Solomon is talking about is synergy here. When we work together, the whole becomes greater than the sum of its parts. And he continues, for if they fall, and I want to tell you, I don't care how wonderful you are, how great you are, I don't care how long you've been in Christ, everyone at some point is going to fall. Jesus, the perfect Son of God, Lamb of God, see, seeing that he tripped under the weight of the cross, and someone had to come alongside to help him bear it. As perfect as he was, his assignment required help. For if they fall, one will lift up his companion. Everyone needs somebody to check up on them. But watch this next verse. He uses a big word, woe, which is akin to cursed. But woe to him who is alone when he falls, for he has no one to help him up. There's an African proverb I often say to you, if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, we got to go together. And Thomas came back to church. Thomas came back to his faith community. Thomas once again rejoined his brothers and sisters. Verse 20 and 25. The other disciples therefore said, more literally in the Greek, kept on saying, we have seen the Lord. You know, at times, I'm pretty sure Scottie Pippen didn't like Dennis Rodman. I don't know if I always liked Dennis Rodman. Other times, Pippen wasn't happy with Jordan, and Jordan wasn't happy with Pippen. But they had rings to get and a job to do. Never let your pain become larger than your purpose. Listen, as saved as I am, I don't like everything about everybody. But I get over it. Because I have a job to do that's bigger than me, my feelings, and my preferences. Pay attention. So Thomas said to them, and you can hear the anger in his voice. It's almost like he's gritting his teeth. Does anyone other than me at times get angry? Yeah. Thomas said, unless, have you ever been so hurt, so disappointed, just the thought of getting to the other side, you can't quite imagine. Unless I see in his hands, he's so disappointed. I thought he was the Christ. I thought he was the Son of the living God. And he hung on that cross. He let them be. Unless I see in his hands the print of those nails. See, I know we think that we're reasonable and rational people. But the truth is, we are far more emotional than we'll ever admit. You see, we believe what we want to believe, and we don't believe what we don't want to believe. And we don't do this purely based on emotions. I know you're educated and all the rest of the stuff. But often our decisions, because we kind of feel a certain way about a thing. And Thomas was asking, how could a loving God let such an evil thing happen to an innocent man? Where was God in the face of such injustice and such suffering? How can I trust God? If he let that happen to him, what might happen to me? And when we look at injustice, we look at suffering, when we look at pain, it's easy to start questioning, God, where are you? Could you really be there? And I want to tell you this morning, I have numerous degrees, but I still don't have all the answers. I just know the one who does. But I do want to add, the thing that has wooed me over the years, particularly when things didn't make sense, is unlike the great pantheon of gods and all the rest, the God I serve does not allow human suffering, but cowardly sit in eternity beyond its reach, just kind of looking at it as his experience and experiment and kind of messing with us. Instead, he became one of us and then endured the worst of us. Then got back up in 3 days to show us the worst day of your life doesn't have to be the last day of your life. Pay attention to what I'm saying. As bad as it was on Friday, if you hang on in there, Sunday is on the way. And sometimes you got to go through Friday to get to Sunday. I can't explain it. I don't always understand it. But though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, oh, I wish he'd just walk me around. But though I walk through the valley, I keep walking with him and walking with him. And Sunday will come if you keep walking. Unless I see in his hands. See, we don't worship an unavailable and indifferent God, but one who is moved with the feelings of our infirmities, tempted on all points as we are, yet without sin. I serve a God that got holes in his hands, a hole in his side, scars in his head. He knows what life is like. Unless I see in his hands the print of nails. Now here's the deal, the backstory. Jesus had prophesied over and over and over again that he'd be crucified and on the third day he'd get back up again. Then the other apostles just told Thomas, he said, listen, Thomas, we saw the Lord, he's risen. And then on top of that, five other women, actually a little bit more, had seen him, Mary Magdalene, the woman that the Bible calls the other Mary, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, Salome. All of them declared the tomb was empty. But because of his pain, Thomas demanded radical and extreme proof. Because we won't believe what we don't want to believe. And we're like, well, Lord, if you show up in a burning bush like Moses, but God's like, look in the heavens, where do you think them stars came from? Do I really need to show up in a bush? Unless I see in his hands the print of the nails and put my finger, now he's mad, and put my finger into the nails. Now all the Old Testament prophets, again, the teaching of Jesus, the testimony of the other apostles, and the empty tomb was already evidence enough to appeal to conscience and any thinking man. And this may surprise you, but few things come with 100% intellectual certainty. All we really usually get with God is a reasonable confidence that grows with time and relationship. Can anyone in this room scientifically prove that George Washington was our first president? Were you there? Can anyone scientifically prove that your mother loved you? Can the scientific method prove the moon landing? Yet we are confident. Maybe there's more to life than science. Yes, sir. And Thomas said, not only do I need to put my finger in the hole in his wrist, I need to put my hand in his side, which is pretty gross. Thomas was upset. But he also revealed the truth of his heart in this next statement. Pay attention. He said, I will not believe. Meaning Thomas made a choice. Doubt in the face of evidence is a choice. Yes, sir. Think about all we must ignore to doubt the existence of God. But we still do. You know, the earth just happens to be perfectly sized to sustain complex life. The earth's size and its gravity is so perfectly designed that it holds just a thin air, a layer of mostly nitrogen and oxygen that extends only 50 miles above the earth's surface. If the earth was any smaller, it would be like Mercury and no atmosphere to speak of could exist. If Earth was any larger, the atmosphere would be like a swirling storm as it is on Jupiter. Earth is the only known planet equipped with the right mixture of gases to sustain plant life, human life, and animal life. Coincidence? The Earth just happens to be located at just the right distance from the sun. If the Earth was just 10% further, we'd all freeze. 10% closer, we'd all burn up. Another coincidence. Our moon just happens to be the perfect size and distance from the earth for its gravitational pull to affect the ocean tides. And without the movement of the ocean, the water would be stagnant and all the fish would die. And not only that, if the tides were not moving and the moon wasn't doing what it did, all the oceans would spill across all the continents. Another coincidence. If gravity was just slightly, I mean almost microscopically, more powerful, the universe would collapse into a ball. If it was slightly less powerful, the universe would fly apart, all the stars, the sun, the moon. As intricately as our world and universe is designed, it only makes sense to consider the idea that an infinite mind must exist somewhere behind it all. We could be here for an hour talking about these things, but do you know the freezing point of water? If it was any different, the planet would be so different. But you know, 32 degrees, it freezes. I don't remember the boiling point. I'm wondering something, somebody said, but whatever it is. Any different, we wouldn't have the polar caps. We wouldn't have the frozen water. Everything would be different. Just a little change. But all of that is put together. Do you know how complicated a single cell is? Do you know how complex the DNA, that not your whole body, just a single cell? I mean, could you imagine for a billion years throwing up, you know, 100 letters and finally them coming down in a precise order? And then something all of a sudden comes out of nothing in the precise order. Can anything ever come from nothing? No. But somehow in our thinking, because life has happened and we've been disappointed, we look up and wonder, is there a God? And after 8 days, his disciples were again inside. According to the Jewish method of counting, this would be the Sunday after the resurrection. And Thomas was with them. Keep showing up even when it hurts. Because if you choose to hang out with winners, you'll eventually become one. And Jesus came, pay attention to what it says. He didn't need a door. The door's being shut. And you could try to lock Jesus out if you want, but he still remembers how to walk through any and every wall that might be put up in our lives. And he stood up in the midst, and he said something I wouldn't have said. I mean, after all the smack Thomas had been talking, I'd have some words. But Jesus stood in the midst, he said, peace to you. God ain't mad at you. You know, God's peace is not the calm that comes after the storm. It's the peace he wants to give each of us during the storm. Then Jesus said to Thomas, you see, Thomas didn't know that Jesus was listening. How often have we lived like God's not watching? Like God's not listening? So Jesus is like, okay, big guy, I hear you, okay. Mm-hmm. He calls his bluff. He said, I hear you, okay. Reach your finger here, like you've been saying. And look at my hands, and reach your hand here, and put it in my side. He's like, you bad. Okay. And he add, don't be unbelieving, but believing. In other words, Thomas, this is a choice. You need to cut it out. Stop letting your emotions overpower your intelligence. Sometimes it takes time for the brain to catch up to what the heart already knows. And Thomas answered, and this is important because Thomas was Jewish. And Jews at this time in history, from the time they were children, the Ten Commandments were ingrained into them. And the second commandment is you shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. Matter of fact, they wouldn't say Yahweh, Jehovah, however you want to pronounce it. They would say other words because no one wanted to ever misspeak the name of God. So what Thomas is about to say was a huge statement. And Thomas answered him and said to him, watch this, my Lord. You see, when you're in that emotional place despite where Thomas was, Jesus was willing to reach him where he was. He wasn't just Lord. In that moment, my Lord, Thomas, you're willing to reach me in my doubt, my anger, my frustration. You weren't intimidated. You didn't back up. God, you were able to handle me. And now I call you my Lord, but watch the next, and my God. Thomas knew what he was saying. They didn't say OMG like Americans, or you would not do it. You get stoned for that in this time. He was saying that Jesus was the first uncaused cause. He's the uncreated source of all creation, the Alpha, Omega, beginning and the end in human form. And if that were not true, and if Jesus was at least a prophet worth his salt, he would have had to correct that statement. But it was true. So Jesus said this to him as his follow-up. And I'm already in our last verse. Thomas, because you have seen me. So Jesus' response here tells us that Thomas obviously didn't have the nerve to shove his arm into Jesus' side, because it didn't say because you touched me. But because you what? Seen me, you have believed. You see, Thomas arrived at this conviction by means of his senses. But there's a higher blessing for those of us who are open enough in spirit to simply respond to his voice, to respond to conscience, to respond to the testimony of the most basic intellect. All of humanity, I mean, atheism and all that other stuff, all of that's pretty new. It took centuries of being out of nature, unable to look at the star, unable to look at wildlife. We had to come into these cocoons to all of a sudden say there is no God. But the most ancient man understood that I'm more than what you see on the outside. There's an inside me, and I must have came from somewhere. You know, if you found a Coca-Cola can, as simple as a Coca-Cola can is, if you went to the moon and found the can, what would you guess? Oh, someone must have been there. And even before they knew about DNA, the distance of the sun, you know, from the earth and the rotation of the planet, before they knew any of that, they had enough common sense to say, you know what? This is too intelligent. This is too orderly for there not to be a mind behind it. So men from every nation and women began to cry out to the Creator God. They said, Thomas, blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed. Blessed are those who see it before they see it. You don't have to be 100% intellectually certain. When I met Jesus 20 years ago, and as I told you before, I was reading the Quran, so I was in the wrong book already. But God knew I was crying out to him, and he reached out to me. And this Jesus thing, you know, I wasn't from, you know, my mom went to church sometime. Dad, you know, that's another thing. So I wasn't from a religious family. Intellectually, I didn't understand it all. But how could creation not recognize its creator when he's present? And when you experience the presence, I'm not talking about church. I'm not talking about churchianity. When you experience the presence of God, it will change your life. You don't know where it came from, where it's going. You can't control it, but you know it's greater than you. As certain as my mother's love, I know that God is, because I've experienced his presence. How do I know that? I don't always know it in my mind, but I know it in my spirit. The deep and true me has experienced God. And one day God moved upon my heart, moved upon my conscience, and I stepped out and took a step of faith. And some of you say, I will not get out until I'm absolutely sure. But I tell you what, Peter, all he needed to hear was Jesus say, come. Yes. And he got out of the boat and experienced what no other man before him experienced. And if you want to experience Jesus, you're going to step out of your boat. You're going to have the courage to take a risk and a chance. Because at first, mentally, you don't have it all figured out. But I will tell you, as you walk with him, it becomes more and more sure. It's like a light dawning, you know, in the morning. It's like sunrise. It gets clearer and clearer. You get more and more confident. And this is the confidence we have in approaching God, that there's a boldness. All that arises. Like my mother, I can't scientifically prove she's in Florida live streaming right now. Hope she is. But I know it. Scientifically, I can't prove it. I guess I could if I got on the plane. But the thing is, no one lives life with 100 certitude about everything. You flew a plane. You didn't even know the guy was drinking before he got behind that thing. You didn't check the fuel gauge, but you got in. So how is it when you come to the most trustworthy, the most honorable, the most faithful being that has ever existed? You need all this, that you got to get it under the microscope. What God is saying to many of you in the overflow as well as in this room, get out of the boat. Step out in faith. Taste and see that the Lord is good. And confidence will grow and build. But you have to take that step.
Yes, sir.
So right now, with every head bowed, every eye closed, God is tugging on your heart right now. He said, you don't need any more proof. You can sense me saying, come. You don't need another word preached, another song sung. All that's left is for you to respond. So in these last moments, the three groups, I want to lift their hands on this Resurrection Sunday, and you're about to be resurrected on the inside. Change is about to come. If you have never really committed your life to Jesus, you kind of felt him at times, but you never really stepped out of the boat. You never really stepped into trusting in faith. In a moment, I'm going to ask you to lift your hand. The second group, perhaps at some point you walk with the Lord, but life happened, things happened, just like with Thomas, and you couldn't handle it. And you backed up, walked away. Jesus saying, come back. The third group, is there anyone here, overflow as well as in this room? You need a pastor. Everyone needs a pastor. You need someone to get on your nerves every Sunday. You need a church community. All a church is company as you walk home. You need people going in the right direction. Now we got all different types of folks, some more sideways than other folks, but we're all in progress and we're all trying to go somewhere. But we all need to be in community. So in a moment, at the count of three, if there's any in this room, you fall into any one of those three categories, I want to see your hand up. One, two, three. Say, I'm that one. I'm that one. I'm that. I see those. I see that hand. I see. Would you stand up? Stand up. All of it. Would you stand up? Stand. Come on. Stand up. Stand up. Stand. Yep. I see you. Would you come? Would you come? I just want to get you. Yep. Come. We have folks that want to pray with you. Come from all over the room. Come. God bless you. God bless you. Come on. Step out on the water. He who called you is faithful. He loves you. He's for you. God bless you, son. God bless you. May your life never, ever be the same. They're going to pray with you. God bless. May your life never, ever be the same. God bless you. God bless you. They're going to pray with you. God, may your life never, ever be the same. God bless you. God bless. Oh, young one, it takes courage. God bless you. May your life never, ever, ever be the same. God bless you. God, welcome. May your life never, ever be the same. God bless you, sir. May your life never be the same. God bless you, sir. God, may your life never be the same. God bless. May your life never be the same, son. May your life never be the same. God bless. God, healing and recovery. This guy's not supposed to be alive, but look at God. Complete healing and restoration in Jesus' name. God bless you. God bless you. Welcome, welcome. Well, God bless you. May your life never be the same. God bless you. May your life never, ever be the same. God bless you. May your life never, ever, ever, ever be the same. God bless you. May your life never, ever be. God bless you, sir. May your life never be. God bless you, man. May your life never, ever, ever, ever. Give God a great big old hand clap. Come on, it's not too late. If anyone else needs to come, we're here. This is why we're here. Yep, there's more coming from Overflow. Let them come. Let them come. This is what this Sunday is all about. He's the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. The angels are rejoicing. God's people are rejoicing. God has a plan for you. Yep, there they come. There they come. There they come. Hallelujah. Come, come, come. Yep, yep, yep. There's no distance. Welcome, Mother. God bless you. Welcome to the family. Oh, may your life never, yeah, Jesus. Jesus, may your life never be the same. Hey, son, I'm so proud of you. God bless you. May your lives never be the same in Jesus' name. Give them a great big hallelujah. Now listen, church. Before the worship team comes and sing a benediction, God has entrusted us with the folks we saw go into those rooms. Pray for them this week. Pray that they get a revelation of God, that there's a strength that rises up on the inside of them. Also, during these altar calls, that's not all about me. It's about us praying. Let's pray together during those calls that none that should respond would be left without responding. Father, I pray a blessing upon everyone that's in this room. Father, may the words of what we read in Scripture go deep into our hearts. And we thank you for the bodies that were healed and things that you started in lives today. In Jesus' precious name, amen and amen.
Amen, 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 amen. Let's bless God one more time. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah, yeah, amen. Well, listen, if it's your first time visiting with us, Bishop and Pastor will be up to your front right to greet you. And if you are in need of further prayer, our ministry team will be up to your front left to pray with you. And now we're going to sing the blessing over you.
The Lord bless you.
Lord bless you.
And keep you.
And keep you.
Make his face.
Make his face shine.
And be
upon.
Gracious.
Be gracious.
The Lord
turn
his face.
Face toward
and give. Sing,
I'm
bless you. God bless you. Have a wonderful week.